Okay, today I'm here working on my spark plug wires, and I've went ahead and cut my wires to the length of what I took out. B1 is the B bank, goes on the left side. I went ahead and slipped these little labels on here. They're a white heat shrink, and they had a nice B1 printed on them, so I went ahead and slipped that on there. The wire I use, you can see it's a CC7N. It's a 7 millimeter ignition wire, and it's got 10 copper core, and the copper core is important. The ones with the fiber core, the real soft conductor going in the middle, these have an actual wire, and when I put these on the end, these little brass pieces, they go down inside the distributor, and with the screw ends, you got to have that type on there. If you got the plug-in type, I think you can buy those. I think Albert sells them, that you can use the regular modern type of plug on the end of the wire, but these, you got to have the wire to crimp around the little brass contacts at the end. But basically, I use some dielectric silicone, and it's a lubricant, and it is for electronic ignition, so it is not a real conductive substance. But to get this stuff on there, it's a lot easier if you put that on there. But I took these off. I had a new set of spark plugs that I took these off. I don't have a part number for them. But anyway, they slip on there quite easily with that silicone, I call it grease. And then you want to get this on there, and you make sure you get the threaded end towards the what's going to be the distributor cap. And then I'm going to go ahead and take and strip the end off of this a little ways, like so, and you'll see there's a wire in there, and that is a hard wire. And I'll get one of my little connectors, and I'll put that wire through there. You can see that. And then I'm going to take these wires, and I'm going to spread those out a tad so that they kind of go all the way around that. I'm going to push them down. Make sure that connector's all the way up. Then I'm going to take a pair of snips, and I'm going to snip off the excess. So I stripped them just a tad long, sort of that. So that's good. Now that'll go down into the distributor, and that presses that on down as it goes in and makes a good contact. Now, from that point, you got to start putting your, that will be one, but I'll get the rest of them made, and we'll go B1, B2, B3, B4. And as you go through these, the next step will be putting these on. Now, some people slit these, which you can see this one slit. I don't like the slit ones, so I'm going to use a one that isn't slit and replace that. People split those because they put the spark plug wire on, and it's easier to put the wires through them, but I'm kind of a perfectionist, so I don't like mine split. If yours are split, I would recommend putting a couple of layers of electrical black tape underneath them. But I'm going to go ahead and do that to the other three wires on the B bank side, then we'll go ahead and get them dressed out. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to slip this on there, this boot, and I got these from Albers. I'm going to go ahead and put a little that silicone lubricant in here because you're going to have to slip that over the retainer. And I'm going to put a little bit of, actually quite a bit of lubricant in there because I want it to slip over the fittings quite easily. And I'm going to start with B1. And I'm going to go ahead and shove it through there. It will be on the lower side because it goes down and it's always the lower one as you go around. And you'll see I got B1 or B1 there. And then I'll go with B2. And coming out, you can see it cross there, but I want that to be on top. So I make sure I get it on top. And you can slide all this back and forth later, but I got B1, B2, and then I'll take B3, and I'll put it through there, and I'll make sure it comes out on top. I really don't want to twist them inside this boot. So I got, as you can see there, I got 1, 2, 3. And so I'll put 3 in there. Okay, and then the last one is 4. And I'll kind of push it down, but B4. Come in there and come to that side. Kind of get in there, and then I'll put B4 in. Now, simply, what you do is this thing with that lubricant pops right up there, and I'm able to pull these back and forth like that. You can see I've got the covers and the screw, and I've got the contacts on the end. And now down here, I'm going to take one of my slip-through boots. Where's the one I had a while ago? Those are all cut. Okay, I'm going to take this one, and simply I'm going to make sure I get them in order. So I've got B4s at the top, and I've got B3. I got B2, and then I'll put B1 in. And I do that keeping B1 at the bottom, basically, because it goes on the bottom all the way across the side of the engine. But now, to get this in there, I'm going to put a little bit of lubricant on it so she slips right in. And this is a dielectric lubricant, but basically that slips in like that. And goes like that. Okay, so that's my boot on there, and you'll see with that lubricant I can move these in and out to adjust them. This gets 3 of these supports on this side, and these are your brackets that hold it onto the frame. You'll notice a couple of those connectors there I got CAD plated accidentally, but anyway, so I'm going to go ahead and put 2 more of these boots on, and actually I'm going to go clean these up a little bit before I put them on. Okay, I cleaned those up with a little lacquer thinner, but I'm going to start and do the same thing. I'm going to keep them straight. Do 1. Two. Three. 4. Okay, and then I get one more of them. You know, sometimes you order new spark plug wires, and I've got them from Tony. I've got them from Albers, Tony up at Hypens in Canada. But these older ones, if they're in good shape, they're actually a little bit smaller in diameter on the inside than the newer ones you get. So I like using these older ones if you've got ones in good shape. Now, on the ends of these, you get these, and these go on the spark plug, and I get them from CarQuest. They come in a box, a quantity of 10, which you use 8 of them. I don't know. Maybe there's 10 cylinder cars, but I always have 2 left over. But TN16 is the number of them, and they're a nice boot. And to get these on, I lubricate the wire, a little bit of my silicone gel, okay, and I'm going to put a little lubricant in the end of these, and as I go on, I twist them like such. Now, you'll get up there and you'll hit that corner. I hope I can do this, but if you twist them and try to flatten it out a little bit as you twist them, they go right on through. And I'm going to put a little bit more lubricant up this wire. But what I do, pull that through a ways. I'll pull it through a good ways because what I'm going to do is put this on the car, and I see a lot of these where there's all kinds of extra over the distributor. I'm going to dress these out on the car. I've left a couple extra inches on them from the ones I took off which had extra length. But I'm going to snip them off and put the connector on after I start dressing them out on the car. That way I'll get them to the exact length and there won't be a bunch sticking out on top. Okay, I put A1 in, A4 goes here, A3 and A2. So I went ahead and put them in the distributor cap. Now you'll notice the bend here goes in. And the washer goes on the inside, so I'm going to go ahead and put that T-bolt in there. And it sets there just like that. And I'm going to get that started. Like such. And I'm going to make sure I got an even curve with all of those. And it comes out of there just like that. And the next one, I got to take this bottom water pipe out. And you'll notice this is a different type clamp here. I got it on there the wrong way. I just put them on there to hold the position. But the way that slant goes in, the firewall is awful close to the back of this engine. So that tucks it in. And if you put it the other way, I think it'll bang on the wires and such that you got on the manifold. And this one's also the same way. It tucks in there just like that. So that curved end goes in towards the engine. Sets in there like that. And these are different sizes. This one's got a little indent to it where this one doesn't. And the bottom one doesn't. So you got to get the right clamps. I always mark them so I get them in the right place. Okay, the next one I'm going to do is this bottom water bolt. And I'm going to put the bolt through it, put the washer on the inside, and then I'm going to get it started in that hole. Okay, like such. Now these are going to come on around here. And I got the last one to put on. I'm probably going to have to move the camera. But, got them going down there. And these will be routed around there like that. So I'm going to get a nice position and tighten them all down. But I like that right there. So none of them are laying on the engine. I'll go ahead and tighten that top bolt down. You know, some people put the washers on the top, and if you put the washers on the top, they tend to slide on you as you tighten down, and the washer's meant to be on the inside. So I think I got that one good and snugged on there. And I want to make sure these wires over here are not touching anything as I tighten that bottom one down. Kind of dress down there nice like that. And now I'll go ahead and tighten the bottom one down. Okay, what I'm doing now is I'm putting the ends on the spark plug. Now, I ran these down there and checked where they need to go, and I pulled them in. I always put a little bit of extra, but I don't like a lot of sloppiness in my wires going around. So that's right where the spark plug needs to go in. So what I do is I pull it out about a half inch and cut it off, because you're going to need some working there. And then I pull it out so I can get my connector on it. But the first thing I do is I strip off a little bit of that so I expose the wire. And I pull these wires back, usually in a couple of places. And I do them towards the bottom. And the end of the connector here, and these are connectors made for those boots I showed you, and they do have a pin in them that pierces and gives you a pretty good connection, but I like to bring the wires back in there, and I like to get them so those wires are towards the bottom. So I shove the end in there and then kind of push it down on that sharp point. And I got a special tool here, and for whatever reason these handles keep slipping off, but this has got an A crimp and a B crimp, and when you do the A crimp, I don't know if you can see that, but you want the big part of the circle on the top, and I start crimping from the inside. Oh, the handles are slipping like crazy. I guess it's all the silicone. And I work my way out. And go in maybe four places. And that one I'm going to kind of go sideways a little bit and make sure I'm closing around it. Now the next crimp you got is the B crimp. And the B crimp I like to have the little thing that mushrooms it in on top, and the round part. When I say the part with the slit. And we'll get that right there. We'll go in several times. And that was a little out of round, so I'm going to work around and make it round again. But they'll look like that when you get them done. A good crimp. And then what I do is I put a little of that, well, quite a bit of that, good spot of it, that silicone on there, because you got to pull it through the boot and you don't want to bend things up. So I get some silicone on it and I get it started the right way. And then I just go ahead and pull them. Trying to get it so you can see them. I go ahead and get stuck a little and pull them right in the boot like that. And that's how I do them, but I pre-measure them so I don't have a lot of slop, and I've done the other three on there, so I'm going to go ahead and get this bracket on there. Okay, you can see I got that's A1 here. I've got them all routed along here. The B A4, it kind of loops out of that bracket and comes up. And I put that bracket on. It took a short T-bolt, the machined head ones, and that bracket you'll see is pulls it out from the, it separates it, so you want to put it on so it stands out, not in. And coming around here to the back, comes up and everything's nicely dressed. And coming into the distributor, we've got a nice arc coming in and a nice clean. I might mention, I can't find my Christmas trees, but there's a little Christmas tree that holds these two wires together, and there's one that goes on and back, so there's two Christmas trees. I'll have to find those and put them on. Okay, I went ahead and put the B-bank on here, and you'll notice I got the curve on them nice, and I come on down and there's a bracket and it's on the inside. You don't want to put it the other way facing out or you get too close to the block. And by the way, the bulkhead, and by the way, these are a bear to get on there, and this one I think most people struggle with the most down here. And you can see it's made so it goes in too. And both of those are T-bolts. And coming on around here, this is your third one. And it's got a 7/16 inch T-bolt that holds that on. And then these will lace up onto the spark plug. So I've got a nice length on them, and I'm not going to put the spark plugs in right now and snap them in, but there's a couple of those trees that go on here and hold the bottom two. By the way, the B1 goes on the bottom, B2 goes next, so going up from the bottom, the B4, which goes to this spark plug, it's on top. And that's the same as the other side, A1, A2, A3, A4, from bottom to top. Okay, and last but not least, we got to do the wire that goes from the center of the distributor into the Lucas coil. And on a Cloud 3, they're a silver coil. And on a Cloud 2, they are a black coil. They're a black coil on a silver Cloud 2. But anyway, I've already stripped the ends of my wire, and I'm going to get a little of my dielectric slick stuff. I'm going to put a little bit on each end and smear that around real good so I can pull the sleeves on it without too much hesitation. Okay, and then I'm going to go ahead. Now, one end of this is a bigger boot that goes over this. So you need to make sure you get the right ends on this so you take them off. And we'll slide that guy on there. And the end that goes in, the screw end, is longer. You can see the two different ones there. The one that goes in the distributor is shorter. I kind of messed up some of my wires. But that slips on there. Okay, and then it gets one of these little cup things. And they're a spring cup, they're a pressure cup. They put pressure as you tighten it down. And I'm gonna put that in there. Yeah, got a wire bad. There we got it on. And then you kind of spread those wires out like we did on the spark plug wires. And I like to press them down. And then I'm going to trim the ends of those off. I've used these plier cutters a lot, side cutters, and they're not quite as sharp as the ones I was using for the spark plug wires. And there we go, that end's ready to go into the distributor. And or ready to go into the coil. Now on this end, you get the smaller boot, and it's similar to the ones that go on the distributor, even though it's a tad longer. And you put this guy on there, make sure you get the screws out. And then you put your spring clip on there. And you spread the wires out again. Press them down and trim them off. Okay, and that's ready to go in the distributor. And I think I'll go ahead and put that in the distributor now. And I don't have the coil on yet, but I'm going to put the coil on the car here in a little while. To complete the spark plug wiring, I went ahead and put it in the middle, and this is the one with the longer screw in, and if it goes all the way in and hits that contact right before it bottoms out, so there we go, and I'm going to go ahead and pop that cap on there. Like so. And that's a longer cap on that. I don't know, it snaps on there if you get it right. Okay, to kind of go on with the spark plug wires here, there's a big spacer that goes on, and it goes on a stud down there. I'll show it to you, but this goes on like that. It's going to mount to the bottom of the block. And there's a stud in there, so it's going to get a washer and a nut on it, and that's a standard 7/16 head nut. Okay, I'm going to zoom on that stud that heat shield goes on, and it goes on the stud right there. So we'll work to get that on there. Okay, I got that nut on there, that spacer and washer. And you can see that goes right there. I'm gonna leave that a little bit loose because I have not put those Christmas trees on those spark plug wires that go on there yet. So I'll wanna get those on there before I tighten that down because it's a little hard to get the, pull it tight and get that behind there. Okay, I'm working on putting the starter in now. And it gets these big bolts, and of course there is a washer on those, so we'll have to get those washers on there. And it goes in the back of the engine. You can see the three holes here. This is where the bolts go in and back, the top one there. And the starter, of course, goes in the other side, and it fits in this hole right here. And I don't know if you can see the flywheel in there. And then it will have an electric lead that comes over and comes to the solenoid. And it's just a short little lead, and we'll get that one on there too. Okay, I'm hoping you're going to be able to see this. But probably not, but... Anyway, I'm going to go ahead and shove this starter up in there. And it's kind of a bitch to get up in there.
get it going in that hole. And then it goes in. I'm hitting something. There she goes. And I got that bolt at the top. I'm gonna get that one started. Okay, got that one started. Now I'm gonna take another one. Put it in the next hole. And that one gets started. And then the last one, which is by the camera here, is going to go in that last hole. And I got the washers on there, but that's going to hold that in while I go and let me take a better picture of that on the outside. And you can see it's mounted up in there. At least I think you can see it's mounted up in there. And these terminals here, we'll talk about putting the wire on. Okay, I've got me a 9/16 inch wrench here, and these are a bitch to get at when you have the body on, but it's pretty easy to tighten these up, and I'm going to snug the tight one up here. There's a ground wire that goes on in here, and I'm going to have to check where it goes because I really don't remember. It runs up to the body and it connects to the block down there somewhere, so I need to double check where that goes. I don't really remember which one. I don't think it goes under one of these though. But basically I'm going to tighten the other two, and that'll have the starter in, and then we'll put the wire. I'm putting on this, this goes from the starter, the top of the throwout solenoid, to the starter solenoid with the push button on it. And it's a short piece, and I made this, and I made it out of the old-fashioned type cloth-covered wire. And I've got it bent so it goes in there just about right. And so I'm going to get my nut started on it and get that in there. Okay, that gets a lock washer. And the solenoid comes with this thin nut. I like to use bigger nuts on the other side. They're copper bolts, but I'm going to go ahead and use this one and get it in. Okay, the start on the throwout solenoid on the starter, I'm going to use a little bit thicker canyon plated bolt and a lock washer, so maybe you can see that when it's the end with the boot on it. And I usually leave both ends loose so I can move it around a little bit and bend it so it's just right for going on there and not touching anything. So I'll get a half inch wrench and tighten those down. Just a note on the starter solenoid with the button, I had to get a 12 millimeter wrench. That is a reproduction push button solenoid. And I don't remember who I bought it from, but it has 12 millimeter bolts on it, so you can work on it with a half inch wrench, and it doesn't tighten down very good. But I got both sides tightened down, and I'm going to slip the boot. Okay, you can see where I've got it on the starter solenoid there. It's a bitch getting in there. And coming around to the other side, you can see I've got the boot on right there. So I'm good to go. Okay, today I'm working on the bypass, and I put the hose clamps on, and I have the old style with the slotted head. And I'm going to use some ultra black
gasket sealer. And I'm going to go ahead and put it on the gaskets here so they seal up real nice when I get it on there. Doesn't take a lot of it, but get a little bit on both sides. Like so. And I'll go ahead and do the other one. Okay, got those all nice and greased up. Then the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to use my Indian head gasket slack. And I'm going to go ahead and put it on here to help seal the hose when I put it on. It also helps the hose slide on there. So when I put the hose on there, like so, it allows me to slide it on there a little easier and to work it. And there is a top and a bottom, so you got to keep them straight on the hose. It goes up like that. And you got four bolts with washers that hold it on, but I'm going to go ahead and stick these on. I'm going to stick a bolt in it to kind of hold it. Like so. And then I'm going to go over to the front of the engine and put that on. And here we go. I've got these nuts, or these bolts, started. That sealant in there allows that to slip around. I've got the wire. These were the hose clamps where I can get to them if I ever have to. This one here is kind of a pain. You got to use an opened-end wrench because the bottom of the hose hits on it, but that's how it goes on the car.